to the Jackson State Basketball Highlight Show. I'm your host, Rob J. The SWAC basketball season is underway as Jackson State open play on the road against in-state rival Alcorn State in Lorman, Mississippi. I will have highlights of that game for you in just a moment. Also, Jackson State opened the home portion of its SWAC schedule here at the Athletics and Assembly Center against Alabama State. Highlights of that game for you as well. Also in this show, we'll take a look back at the 2022 sports season here at Jackson State, which was filled with a lot of highs and a few lows, but mostly highs. But first, my conversations with Jackson State head men's basketball coach Mo Williams and JSU head women's basketball coach Tamika Reed. Coach, first of all, thank you for joining me. And just talk about how the season is already underway. The SWAC season is underway, and you guys off to a really good start.
Oh, man. Yeah, we are off to a really good start. We knew coming into this year that the SWAC was going to be extremely competitive. You know, last year we beat teams by 27, 30, 40 points, and I told the team, nobody's going to allow you to come in and do that this year. And Alcorn did just that. They came in and fought the entire game. And so I'm just really proud of my players for being resilient. And just sure some things that we're going to have to show as we continue to go down the stretch in the SWAC conference play, and that's the composure, resilience, and toughness.
Did you like the fact that you opened up SWAC play against Alcorn, your in-state rival, or did it just fall that way?
You know, it fell that way, and it was a little bit different because normally we open up with Alabama, Alabama State and Alabama A&M, but to open it up with Alcorn was really good for us because it was a more competitive game. And I think our players, our newcomers, our transfers needed to see what the SWAC was really like and how tough the SWAC really is. And Alcorn gave us a great taste of that.
I know you didn't get much production from Maya Crump, and I know she's still suffering from her injury, but you had really great production from Jock Covington and some of the other players. Let's talk about some of the new players that's on this team this year.
Well, I really like our new players' confidence. They bring a lot of confidence to the floor and a lot of toughness, mental toughness to the floor, and that's what we really need. Maya is, she's coming around. She's getting back into her rhythm. And I think once she gets back into her rhythm, we're going to be a really, really good team and a really good consistent team. But Liz Martino does a great job in stretching the floor for us. She's a player that nobody will help off of because she can, shoot the lights out. And Angel Jackson playing on the inside, 7 blocks. I mean, that's a lot of blocks. We haven't had that many blocks since I've been at Jackson State as a head coach. And so to have that energy around the basket is phenomenal. And also, Jaria Covington, she's a leader. She's a tough player. She's a captain for the program. She just does a really good job for us and leading us. And I was just really impressed with the way she played as well. Tyon Bowler, she's been playing extremely good for us as well. She has really elevated the bar. She's exceeded my expectations and what I thought that she would be this year, and I'm just really proud of her. And Jalea Hickman, she's a player that, stats don't really talk about how tough she is, but I mean, she came into the game and had several steals, made several defensive stops, and so, with the way she's playing right now, we're going to be very good defensively, and that's what we have to do. The first preseason, we were an offensive team. And I told the team, you guys have to become defensive. That's who the program has been, and that's who we have to continue to be, because defense wins championships. And I saw us make that turn against Alcorn.
And joining me now is Jackson State head men's basketball coach Mo Williams. Coach, first of all, I got to say congratulations to you on that thrilling win against Alcorn.
Hey, it was definitely a thrilling win. It's definitely a great way to start our SWAC play on the road. We didn't particularly play our best brand of basketball. We missed a lot of free throws, as you know. But we showed a lot of toughness, a lot of grit, and stayed with it, gave ourselves a chance down at the end of the second half. And, Chase made a great pass, Coach made a great shot, and on the defensive end, we don't get him a lot of credit for what he did on defensive end, that same play to force a missed layup, making a shot, getting back on D, and forcing a missed layup for the win.
Well, Coach, when you look at this win against Alcorn, what does this give you guys more confidence now, knowing that they won the conference, like you said,
absolutely,
after the game?
Yeah, absolutely. We knew what we was up against. Obviously, starting SWAC play, obviously you want to get off to a good start. We had to go play the defending SWAC champs on their court. And we knew it was going to be a tough game. We knew we were going to have to fight it out. We knew we had to be tough mentally and physically, and thought we brought those aspects to the game. Typically on the road, playing against a tough team, if you win, typically it's going to be ugly. And that was an ugly win, but we'll take them. You know, and we get a chance to obviously come home and play our first home game on our court against Alabama State. So I'm looking forward to our crowd this weekend. I'm looking forward to our players just feeling comfortable, you know, on their home court. And I think we'll have a lot of energy.
Coach, that's one of the things that you were impressing upon people to come out to the games. Why is that important for you?
It's important for a lot of different reasons. A, it gives us energy. I mean, it gives us energy like no other when we're participating just in a game. But I want people to understand the really importance of them showing up and showing out and being in the seats and being loud and having a vision of this thing just being crowded every single game. Because every game, home game, we bring in future recruits, future guys that's going to be a part of our program. And as a recruit, when you come into a building and it's packed and the atmosphere is amazing, you help as a crowd, as a fan, you help us get guys and get talent in our building the next year and the next year and the next year. Because when I go to a football game, using football as an example, and when they bring in those recruits to come to a game, and that atmosphere is so electric and it's so vibrant, and along with the coaching staff, along with the basketball team, and then all of a sudden you trickle in the fan, the atmosphere, guess what that kid is going to say when he's leaving this institution? I'm coming. You know, I want to attend Jackson State University. So I think from a fan aspect, you do way more than you really think.
Now coming in on Saturday, you got your former team. Mm-hmm. Now, you feel like you got a bullseye on your back with them coming in here?
Well, absolutely. You know, it's just like with anything else. You know, when you was a part of something, it's always going to be a part of you. My 2 years at Alabama State is always going to be a part of me. So, obviously, it's going to be something a little different whenever we play, no matter how long that I'm coaching. It's just going to be that. I expect the same from them. And it goes a little bit further beyond just me coming from Alabama State. It's just the Jackson State and Alabama State. You know, it's just something there. You know, it's just something there. So I'm here for all that.
Well, Coach, congratulations on the win against Alcorn. We'll have highlights for you in just a moment. Anything else?
Well, I just want to say, again, we have 9 home games, and we need you there. We need you in the seats. You know, you just don't know what you do for us, and we look forward to seeing you guys packing out the AAC on Saturday. You got, you know, Alabama State coming in. We want to see you there.
All right, stay with us. We're back in a moment.
No words to describe the perfect pairing of Zaxby's hand-breaded fingers and our 12 delectable sauces. But there is a sound, and that sound is The Zaxby's Chicken Finger Plate with endless sauceabilities, only at Zaxby's.
This is what we work for. The moments you live for. The joy. The heart. The wonder. At Entergy, we're dedicated to powering each moment. Today and for future generations. So we're leading the way with a cleaner, more reliable power grid to power every day. Because these moments matter. We power life. Entergy.
Tongue Torch. Zach Sauce? Tongue Torch and Zach Sauce? With Zaxby's Chicken Finger Plate, the question is not will you sauce those hand-breaded fingers? The question is, can you get extra napkins? Endless sauceabilities, only at Zaxby's.
Health has always been reactive, focused on fixing problems as they happen. But with Blue Primary Care, we're taking a proactive approach, working with you to help you understand your health and empowering you to be healthy. It's time to prioritize you, your health, and your life. The results? Less worrying and more living. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue.
Hey, this is Don Duncan here at Rubin Tire Center. It's fall. That means football, road trips, and good times. Don't let a flat ruin your day. Hop on in if you need a new tire or a tire repair. If your budget's a little tight, we have a large selection of high-tread takeoff tires at a fraction of the price of new. The Riverbend Rabbit has a tire for every budget and every vehicle. Remember, we offer 90 days same as cash and no credit check financing. Two locations in Jackson and one in Flowood. Rabbit is good, Rabbit is wise.
The Jackson State Basketball Highlight Show. Again, here from Lorman, Mississippi, Jackson State opening swag play against the Braves and Lady Braves. Here are your highlights. Three-time defending swag champs Jackson State is expected to have a leg up on its competition again this season. The Lady Tigers are picked to repeat as conference champions and open swag play Monday afternoon against in-state rival Alcorn.
Lady Tigers, Covington pulls from the outside and hits.
JSU closed out the first quarter with a 10-1 run to take a 19-11 lead.
Covington quickly in transition, puts it up, and it's good.
Jaria Covington provided a spark off the bench as she finished with a game-high 17 points.
Covington with 5 points in the ballgame, penetrates, goes up with it, and again, Covington.
Angel Jackson helped JSU build on that lead, and the Lady Tigers went into the break up 33-19.
To Daphne White, Daphne with a series of moves, and then he can't get it to go, and she got it back and put it up and in. She's here, Jackson State inside, Martino with a nice bucket.
I'm not used to this. It's hot in here. It was a lot going on, but we overcame all those difficulties.
Alcorn tried to make it difficult for JSU by cutting the Lady Tigers' lead down to 7 late, but that's as close as the Lady Braves would get. And Jackson State opened swag play with a 59-49 win.
You know, it's a good win. I'm glad we came out on top. We played as a team. I do feel like we could have boxed out, you know, played defense a little bit better, but we came out on top, so that's all that matters.
I think the win was what we needed to see in the SWAC. It was my first SWAC win, and I saw how competitive it was, how hard it was, and how we have to play our game.
On the men's side, Jackson State came out cooking against Alcorn.
Tigers going inside to Cook, who puts it out the way.
Zeke Cook gave the Tigers an early 3-2 lead, and Jamarcus Jones put Jackson State up by 3 with this putback.
A shot from the top for 3 for JSU. Oh!
The Braves then went on a 6-0 run to open a lead they would hold for much of the game. But Jamarcus never let Alcorn pull away, keeping Jackson State close throughout.
Good in and out, rebounded by JSU.
In the second half, Jones never let up as he scored a game-high 26 points.
Oh, nice move by Jones.
Then with the Braves up 4 with a little over 2 minutes left, Colty Young pulled JSU to within 1.
By JSU, 3-pointer for Colty Young.
Alcorn's Keandre Montgomery responded with a 3, extending the Braves' lead to 4.
Pulls for 3, it's...
Ken Evans would step to the free throw line with 16 seconds to play and hit 3 free throws, pulling JSU to within 1.
It is good, he hit all 3.
Alcorn's Byron Joshua went to the line and made 1 of 2 shots, setting the stage for Colty Young's game winner.
Here's the Tigers with 3. The Braves go in, lay it up, and they miss! They miss the win! Jackson State wins! Jackson State wins!
They win!
JSU wins! Wow! 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 Oh my goodness! Jackson State comes to Alcorn and beat the Braves on a 3-pointer! Oh my goodness!
Highlights of Jackson State and the Alcorn Braves and Lady Braves. Now, when we come back, we'll have highlights of Jackson State and Alabama State as the Tigers open swag play at home at the AAC. We're back after this.
Health has always been reactive, focused on fixing problems as they happen. But with Blue Primary Care, we're taking a proactive approach, working with you to help you understand your health and empowering you to be healthy. It's time to prioritize you, your health, and your life. The results? Less worrying and more living.
Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue.
This is what we work for. The moments you live for. The joy. The heart. The wonder. At Entergy, we're dedicated to powering each moment. Today and for future generations. So we're leading the way with a cleaner, more reliable power grid to power every day. Because these moments matter. We power life. Entergy.
There are no words to describe the perfect pairing of Zaxby's hand-breaded fingers and our 12 delectable sauces. But there is a sound, and that sound is The Zaxby's Chicken Finger Plate with endless sauce abilities, only at Zaxby's.
Hey, this is Don Duncan here at Rubin Tire Center. It's fall. That means football, road trips, and good times. Don't let a flat ruin your day. Hop on in if you need a new tire or a tire repair. If your budget's a little tight, we have a large selection of high-tread takeoff tires at a fraction of the price of new. The Riverbend Rabbit has a tire for every budget and every vehicle. Remember, we offer 90 days same as cash and no credit check financing. Two locations in Jackson and one in Flowood. Rabbit is good, rabbit is wise.
Tongue Torch, Zach Sauce, Tongue Torch and Zach Sauce. With Zaxby's Chicken Finger Plate, the question is not will you sauce those hand-breaded fingers? The question is, can you get extra napkins? Endless sauce abilities, only at Zaxby's.
Welcome back to the Jackson State Basketball Highlight Show. After sweeping Alcorn in Lorman, Mississippi, Jackson State opened its home portion of swag play here at the AAC against Alabama State. Now for the Lady Tigers, it was a familiar foe as they faced the Lady Hornets in the swag tournament finals for 2 years in a row. And for the men, it was a chance for Mo Williams to face his former team in the Alabama State Hornets. The JSU ladies did not waste any time putting away Alabama State in their swag home opener. Keshawna Luckett set the tone early, and Angel was divine. Nice feed inside to Angel. Angel, turnaround shot is good. Here's a three-pointer for Angel Jackson, and it's good. Angel Jackson scored 16 points and led JSU on a 13-0 first half run as the Lady Tigers opened a 16-point second quarter lead. Jackson State's defense was led by Maya Crump, who finished with three steals. It was all part of 12 ASU turnovers in the game. The Lady Tigers' offense was clicking on all cylinders as they shot 63% from the floor and cruised to a 90-48 win.
Here's Alexis with a nice move, and she hits! Wow!
On the men's side, former Jackson State head coach Wayne Brent was among those in attendance to see Tigers' new coach Mo Williams against his former team. Colty Young recorded a double-double with 17 points and 10 rebounds as Jackson State jumped out to an 8-point lead late in the first half. Ken Evans Jr. helped JSU maintain that lead throughout the break, and Jamarcus Jones added 11, but Jackson State was never able to pull away from the Hornets. ASU cut the Tigers' lead down to 1 on a pair of free throws by Alex Anderson with less than a minute to play. Then JSU's Kevion Hunt knocked down a pair of free throws with 19 seconds left, giving JSU a 3-point lead, setting up another thrilling finish.
8, Anderson for 3, no good! But they get the offensive rebound, another 3-pointer is no good! And that will do it! Jackson State wins again! His former team as Jackson State holds on to beat Alabama State 61-58. I'm tired, coach.
This is what we work for. The moments you live for. The joy. The heart. The wonder. At Entergy, we're dedicated to powering each moment, today and for future generations. So we're leading the way with a cleaner, more reliable power grid to power every day. Because these moments matter. We power life. Entergy.
Health has always been reactive, focused on fixing problems as they happen. But with Blue Primary Care, we're taking a proactive approach, working with you to help you understand your health and empowering you to be healthy. It's time to prioritize you, your health, and your life. The results? Less worrying and more living. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Mississippi. It's good to be blue.
There are no words to describe the perfect pairing of Zaxby's hand-breaded fingers and our 12 delectable sauces. But there is a sound, and that sound is The Zaxby's Chicken Finger Plate with endless sauceabilities, only at Zaxby's.
Inflation has hit us hard. So here's what C Spire's gonna do. Inflation retaliation. We're giving you 12 months of free service on any new line. Together, we're gonna fight back with our best deal in wireless history. Because in C Spire country, we look after our own. Inflation retaliation. Get your wireless plan free for 12 months with any new line activation. Only in C Spire country.
Tongue torch. Zax sauce? Tongue torch and Zax sauce? With Zaxby's Chicken Finger Plate, the question is not will you sauce those hand-breaded fingers? The question is, can you get extra napkins? Endless sauce abilities, only at Zaxby's.
Welcome back to the Jackson State Basketball Highlight Show. JSU had a very successful 2022 year, and as we begin the new year, we take a look back at the year in review for JSU Sports.
The pain, I rise and fall, yet through
We congratulate all of the success for both JSU on and off the playing surface. That's a look at this week's show. Thanks so much for watching, and join us back next week.